In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of pelvic floor muscles. Particularly, I am going to focus on two muscle groups. One is levator ani, and coccygeus. This is not everything of pelvic floor. These are just part of them. Please remember this. I am going to explain their origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical connection. Okay, first thing first. There are three muscles in levator ani. 1, 2, and 3. I will explain one by one. This white one is pubo rectalis. You can imagine its attachment, its pubis around here, pubis and around rectum. So it's from pubis, then it goes to around rectum. So its shape is like this, surrounding around rectum. It's from pubis and it's run like this. Simple enough. First one is puborectalis. Next one is this yellow one. So what is that yellow one? It attaches on pubis as well, and it attaches to coccyx. So maybe you can suggest its name. It's from pubis, then it attaches to coccyx. So this is pubococcygeus. Pubococcygeus. It originates from pubis. Then it inserts to coccyx. Very simple, right? And what is this blue one? This blue one is a little bit tricky. Its name is iliococcygeus. Iliococcygeus, but it's not ilium. It's more like ischium or pubis, right? Its origin is actually this muscle. Iliococcygeus attaches to fascia of this muscle. What is this? This is obturator internus. So this muscle attaches to fascia of obturator internus. This muscle is part of deep lateral rotator of hip joint. Iliococcygeus attaches to fascia of this muscle. What can you suggest from this anatomy? Maybe when iliococcygeus gets tight, that can affect obturator internus. What happens when this muscle gets tight? Maybe that inhibits movement of hip joint, because this is hip muscle. Vice versa, when obturator internus gets tight, that might affect iliococcygeus. This is very, very important. Knowing attachment of this muscle might help understanding of hip joint knowledge and pelvic floor knowledge. Again, iliococcygeus attaches to fascia of obturator internus. Okay, insertion is this part. This is also coccyx. Iliococcygeus. So these are three muscles of levator ani. Puborectalis. Pubococcygeus. And iliococcygeus. coccygis. These are levator annuli. Now let me explain anatomy of coccygis. Coccygis is this muscle that originates from this pointy part of pelvis. This is ischial spine. Okay, this tiny bony part. And you see this white structure? This is ligament. Coccygis attaches on ligament. This is sacrospinous ligament. Sacrospinous ligament. Okay, this ligament connects ischial spine and sacrum. Okay, this is origin. Insertion is coccyx and sacrum. You see this picture? Coccygis. Levator annuli. These muscles are very, very close to internal organs. For next part, let me explain function of these muscles. Okay, characteristics of these muscles is they are very close to internal organ. Let's say there is bladder just posterior to pubis. Bladder, okay? Posterior to bladder, for female, there is uterus. And posterior to uterus, and in front of sacrum, there is rectum, okay? And deep to bladder, there is prostate for male. Look at that. This space is very, very narrow. In such narrow space, there are many internal organs. So, function of these muscles. So, one of functions of these muscles is support for internal organ. Support. So, when these muscles get tight, or one of these muscles get tight, maybe that can give stress for these internal organs. What kind of organs are they? They are like urogenital organs and digestive system. They are very important for urination and genital functions, right? So, support is main function for pelvic floor. Plus, there's one more function, which is urogenital function. You know, this is end of digestive system and urinary system, right? What is entrance of digestive system? It's mouth, right? Then, rectum and anus are like end point of digestive system, right? So there is urination and such a function happening around pelvic floor. So, supportive system and urogenital function. These are main function of pelvic floor. Now you understand function of these muscles. Now I would like to go back to obturator internus again. Do you remember? Iliococcygis originates from fascia of obturator internus. Do you remember this muscle is one of hip lateral rotators? Again, when this muscle gets tight, maybe iliococcygis gets affected. Again, what are they? What are they? The bladder, uterus, prostate, rectum, anus around here. Maybe tightness of obturator internus can affect urogenital functions and digestive systems. Why? Because there is myofascial connection in pelvic floor. That is why obturator internus is not only for hip muscles, but it is important for pelvic floor mechanics. In this video, I explained basic anatomy of pelvic floor, especially for levator ani and coccygeus. Plus, I explained why obturator internus is important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.